hold down the fort. This is something we say when we're saying we're going to take care of something. We're going to hold down the fort. For example, my coworkers left for the day and it's up to me to hold down the fort.
Now, this guy is running an English language course on YouTube. Now, I can't testify as to the quality of the course. I've literally only watched this 20-second clip. But based on that, it might not be very good because there is no such saying in English.
Hey boys, I'm leaving for Hawaii. Think you guys can hold down the fort?
Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just like a bandit run.
Hello everyone, this is Jason Pope, the Trucker's Coach, coming to you live from the cab of my truck here. Just wanted to make a short video for all the spouses out there that are holding down the fort while we're out on the road.
No, 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 no. The expression is not hold down the fort. It's hold the fort. There's no down in it. Let me try to use an example from your own American history to try and make this point. I'm going to use the Alamo. Now, Santa Ana was advancing, and they decided to make a stand at the Alamo. Santa Ana had to stop and engage the Alamo before he could continue, because had he just gone around it, there would have been a force behind him that could have attacked him from the rear. Now, the people in the Alamo knew that they were outmatched, outgunned, outmanned. But what they had to do was hold the fort. In other words, keep possession of the fort for as long as they could until reinforcements could come or an army could be raised to fight Santa Ana. Is that clear? So it's hold the fort, not hold down the fort. Let me explain further. Now, you should really want to get this right because I know that John Wayne, Richard Widmark, and Lawrence Harvey all died in defense of the Alamo. Lawrence Harvey, good-looking guy, broke my mum's heart, could scarcely have been worse if Rock Hudson had died there, or Christopher Plummer. But just look at the Alamo itself. It's a big stone building. Now, this happened around just a bit less than 200 years after Isaac Newton invented gravity. We all know that prior to Newton, things just used to float around like they do in the International Space Station. But Newton invented gravity, and Newton died in around 1650 or so. The Alamo wasn't until 1830 or so. So gravity was well established, and a big stone building like this would not need holding down. Gravity would keep it firmly stuck to the ground. It needed holding, keeping in our possession, but it did not need holding down. The Alamo was a big stone building. It was not a hot air balloon. So please, 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 let's get rid of the down. It drives me potty. Just last night, I was watching that new Steve Carell thing on Netflix, is it Space Force or something? And he said, hold down the fort. And I just have to go, no, it's hold the fort. You don't need to hold it down. As David Mitchell said in his great treatise on this subject, in David Mitchell's soapbox, it's not an inflatable hover fort. It does not need holding down. It needs holding.